my channel. I'm Morgan Monet. In today's video, I'm giving you guys my full and honest review on my Gucci Dionysus in the medium size. Plus, I'm gonna be showing you what all fits in this bag and how I like to pack it and use it. So this has been a highly requested video and I'm super pumped to be bringing this information and content to you guys just because y'all commented and I'm answering and that's how it's supposed to be. If this is the first time or your first time watching any of my videos, welcome. I create content around luxury accessories such as handbags or small leather goods. I call them SLGs. So if you like these type of videos as well, you should definitely subscribe by hitting the red button below. I feel like it's imperative that we normalize luxury, especially in the Black community. So if you feel that way as well and want to join my Luxe family, I would love to have you. So go on ahead, hit that red button and also hit the bell icon and let's get started. So here she is, you guys. This is my Gucci Dionysus GG Supreme medium shoulder bag and I am obsessed. And I love this bag, which is actually a shock for me, knowing that at least I prefer a tote bag over a shoulder bag. But this has really changed the game when it came to my opinions of overall shoulder bags. So jumping right into the dimensions of this bag, it is 12 inches in width, 8 inches in height, and 4 inches in diameter. And I'm also gonna call out the fact that this is an accordion style bag, which allows you to fit a lot of items into this bag or easily travel with it because you can squish it so that it becomes more compact for travel. I am going to be telling you guys both my pros and cons on this bag. And then if you guys want any other information or have any other questions, you can ask me down below in the comments. So starting off with my pros, I love the material of this bag. So in my opinion, it is 95% canvas and then it's 5% suede. So where you see the GG, this is all canvas. And the reason why I like canvas is I feel like it's stronger. You don't have to worry about water and it's essentially scratch resistant. So knowing that the bag is 95% carefree, I really do gravitate toward that because I don't have to baby this bag. The suede detailing makes up about 5% of the bag because you do have the peaks of it in the front, also on the sides, and then this back pocket. And so sometimes I do get a little hesitant when carrying this bag in the rain because of the fact that if you get rain or water on suede, it can be a little hectic or cumbersome to deal with. But then I also love the fact that it is suede and it gives that material contrast against this bag. This back suede pocket is functional. I can easily fit my phone into this back pocket and it easily accessible. I would call out that if you're someone who wears a lot of dark denim, just be careful when carrying this bag because you wouldn't want the color transfer of your denim to get on the back of this pocket. And then I would also call out that if you're someone who likes to preferably use like a darker lipstick, just be careful when putting it on the inside of the bag because the interior of the bag is also lined with suede. So you wouldn't want to ruin the outside or the interior of the bag. I also want to call out the fact that this bag has the beautiful Gucci Dionysus tiger head. I just think that this detailing on the bag is beautiful and gorgeous. And the fact that they actually, I think they said that they hand make these tiger heads. The next pro I have for you guys is the overall aesthetic or look of this bag. So to me, I feel like my Gucci Dionysus can enhance any outfit that I wear, whether I am in jeans and a t-shirt, all the way down to leggings and a hoodie. I think that this bag truly enhances any look, and mainly because I really do think it's because of the lion head closure, but also because of the chain. So this chain gives off, in my opinion, a very sophisticated vibe, and the fact that you can wear it two ways, so you can either wear it longer or you can wear it shorter, I think that it just adds a different type of level of diversity to this bag. I know that some people hate the fact that it really is loud when it comes to the logos, but in my opinion, I feel like the GG Supreme is more understated than like the Louis Vuitton monogram. Now, that's just my opinion. You guys may feel different, but I do feel like this gives off a more understated logo vibe versus other monogram logos that are out there on the market. Another pro of this bag is the capacity, or the amount of products that this bag can hold. So I've already called out to you guys the fact that there is this back pocket, but if you're to like open the bag, there is initially in the very front another pocket back here, which is deep enough to hold your cell phone, your key fob, lipstick, X, Y, and Z. But then there are also three components, or three areas, in the interior of the bag. So you have the very back, you have this interior zipper pocket, and then you also have the very front. So I like the fact that it can really hold not only like my wallet or my car keys, but it actually holds like my electronic pouch. And I'll show all of you guys that at the end of the video, where I really detail out what exactly fits in this bag. So the last pro I have for you guys is the fact that this bag is considered a classic to the Gucci fashion house. And that's mainly because of the tiger head closure. This style, or this type of closure, is now iconic to the Gucci house, as well as, or along with, the Gucci Marmont and the Gucci bamboo closure. The Dionysus is third type of closure that symbolizes and let people know that it is a Gucci bag. And I love the fact that it's a classic, mainly because I don't have to worry about like reselling it, or if I wanted to resell it, that's an option because it is a classic. But I don't feel like this bag is no longer trendy. I feel like multiple people have it in their wardrobe or in their collection, and it's no longer seen as like a trendier type of a bag. Now, sis, let's get into the cons on this bag. And my first one that I have to call out is the weight. This bag is heavy, you guys. Even when it's empty, like it's empty right now, and it's a heavy bag. So when you add items into it, it only gets heavier. So if you are someone who doesn't typically like heavier bags, especially on your shoulder, then this may not necessarily be the handbag for you. I don't typically mind it, just because I have like two different ways that I can wear it, with like it either being double chained or single chained. But I had to get used to the weight of the bag, and I noticed it fairly quickly, just because carrying it around, I was like, oh my gosh, like this is heavy on my shoulder. The next con I have on this bag is the fact that sometimes getting into the closure, or using the closure, is cumbersome. So right now I don't have my nails on, but when I do, opening and closing this bag is a little tricky, because you have to press this interior like digit to open up or release the flap of the bag. And sometimes it gets caught for me. I don't know if maybe like I'm opening it wrong, or if maybe I've somehow damaged the bag, but the closure is sometimes very cumbersome for me to open up. And then also, because of the Dionysus head, it did make an indent on the suede, which, I mean, it's fine because no one sees it, but that's also a con in my book, just because if I ever did want to resell it, that immediately diminishes the resale value of this handbag. So the last con I have on this video would definitely have to be the price point and resale value. In the boutique, this bag retails for $2,000 $490, and that is before taxes. But if you look at this bag on the pre-loved market, the most I've seen it go for is around $1,800 or $1,900. So there is a large amount difference between what you pay for the bag in the boutique versus what you can resell the bag for later on. And for me, that's a bummer because it's considered a classic to the fashion house, but it does not hold its resale value as much. And I've been trying to like research and understand why it doesn't hold its resale value that much, but I haven't really been able to figure it out. So if you guys know, please let me know in the comments down below, just because that's kind of a big jump to be able to sell it for basically $2,500 and only be able to resell it for at max $1,800. But I personally do not plan on reselling this bag at all. I do plan to keep it in my collection forever. So jumping into showing you guys what all fits in my bag, it is completely filled. And I also have to call out to you guys the fact that it is heavy with me having all of my items in it. I want to make sure that you guys understand that this is a heavier handbag. In the back, I do have my cell phone, which I told you guys that I love to keep my cell phone in this back pocket just because it's easy for me to access. Then if we turn the bag over and open it, I typically do not use this front pocket as often as I should. If it's raining outside, then I'll definitely fit my or put my phone in this initial front pocket. But other than that, I personally do not use it. If we were to jump into this first area of the bag, I do keep a pair of sunglasses. I keep my Louis Vuitton 6-ring key holder. And I also keep my full-size Louis Sarah wallet in this bag. So it does easily fit in the front area of this bag. In the middle, it does have a zipper area where you can either keep this open or zip it closed. I prefer to keep my zipper open just because it's easier for me to be able to access. And on the interior of here, I keep my authenticity papers from Gucci. I also like to keep a pen, and then I also like to keep some type of sanitary items. And then of course I do have an extra pen. And then in the very back of the bag, I like to keep my full-sized agenda just so that I can make sure that I'm staying on track and on schedule. All right, you guys, so that's the end of this video. I hope that you enjoyed my full review on my Gucci Dionysus GG Supreme Medium Shoulder Bag. That is a lot to say. And I hope that you were able to just get some insights onto if the bag would truly work for you with your wardrobe or within your collection. Please let me know your thoughts down below on if you like the bag, if you don't like the bag, or just any other type of information that you could potentially give me in regards to the handbag. I hope to see you guys in my next video. So talk to you soon. Bye!